The string in Java is a reference data type, as are all other non-primitive data types. This means that the variable contains an address to an object in memory, and not the object itself. The string object is created in the memory, and the address to it is returned to the variable. The normal syntax to initiate a reference data type is using the new keyword, which can also be used for strings. To concatenate strings, we have the plus sign, which here is called the concatenation operator. It also has an accompanying assignment operator, which appends one string to another and creates a new string. Note that while we can break a statement across multiple lines, we can't break a string. Instead, we have to split them using the concatenation operator. If we want to add new lines into the string itself, we use the escape character \n. This / notation is used to write special characters, such as / itself or double quote. They also include a Unicode character notation for writing any character. The way to compare two strings is using the equal method of the string class. If we were to use the equality operator instead, it would only compare the memory addresses. Keep in mind that all strings in Java are objects, so we can call methods directly on constant strings, just as well as on variables. The string class has a large number of functions available, but it contains no methods to manipulate strings. This is because strings in Java are immutable. Once a string has been created, the content cannot be changed, unless the whole string is completely replaced. Since most strings are never modified, this was done on purpose to make the string class more efficient. For cases when we need a modifiable string, we instead use the string buffer class, which is a mutable string object. This class has several methods to manipulate strings, such as append, delete, and insert. To convert it back into a regular string, there's the toString method